Hello everyone, I am Saitech and welcome back to my channel Saitech. We're interested today to order the speedtest comparison between the Realme Exynos Max versus IQ 7 device. But I'll try to use this time with a high performance mode and without using any kind of external RAM capabilities in both phones. Yes friends, so these are the requests which I did get in the Realme Exynos Max user thread asking me to use a high performance mode during this time of demonstration. So high performance mode you can turn on by going into the battery, by going into the more battery options. As you can see, this is an option which a lot of users already asked me to use while I'm doing the speed test. Because whenever you try to use the high performance mode, the Realme Exynos Max will perform really good. That is what a lot of users that did advise me to use basically. So let's see friends what will happen. So right now by using the high performance mode and clearing all the background applications as well from the process manager, let's see what will happen, whether I can actually RAM management will be improved in this phone or speed test will be improved or not. That's what I'm going to check right now comparing both phones, which is a Realme Exynos Max and the IQ 7 device. As you can see friends, so both phones are connected to the same Wi-Fi network. First let's check that is the Wi-Fi network. So let me try to open the Wi-Fi. So I just want to connect to the same Wi-Fi network only during this time of demonstration. So it's a 5 GHz as you can see. So now both phones are connected to the same Wi-Fi network. That's completely clean. And there is no external RAM capabilities friends. Let me try to show you exactly. I did turn off the external RAM capabilities in the IQ as well. As you can see, there is no external RAM capabilities during this process of demonstration. I'm not using any external RAM because I do think this is a kind of really gimmick in terms of having the external RAM capabilities. That is the reason I'm not trying to use any kind of external RAM. So right now these are the 10 games which I selected during this process of demonstration. So same 10 games which I selected before. So only these 10 games I did select during this process. Even though I think these games doesn't need any kind of Wi-Fi, but still I just want to show you what is a Wi-Fi connection, that's it. So let's start with the first game, which is a Subway Surf. Let's see friends, by using high performance mode with the speed increase or not in terms of opening the games faster. That's what I'm going to check during this time of testing. So out of 10 games, let's see how many games will be opened faster in the Realme Exynos Max. So both are same, not bad, and get away too. So till now the Subway Surf was opened in the IQ 7 faster than the Realme Exynos Max device. That's the one thing. That's the one bonus point for the IQ 7 device. And this one also is a bonus point for the IQ 7 device as well. And slightly we got that same kind of menu here. Let me go back and let's open the Smash It. Let's see this game Smash It, which will open the first, maybe the IQ 7 device, I think so. But I'll try to keep in the RAM management as a background. Let's see in the Crossy Roads, both are same, not bad. So maybe using the high performance mode, I think the Realme Exynos Max is getting slightly the boosted up in terms of the speed, in terms of the speed of opening the games. That is what I meant. So let's see this game. Yes, it's kind of performing really close to the IQ 7 device friends. Absolutely yes, I can see the difference as well using this kind of option, high performance mode. So before it used to be slightly more difference in terms of the opening these games, but now it's slightly kind of faster. So maybe open using the high performance mode. So if you want to experience really good gameplay, try to use a high performance mode while gaming. So that might give you the real better results. Not bad, both are kind of same. Little bit only difference is there. So final game, let's see friends, this game which phone will be able to open. And both phones did open faster. So now I did open the 10 games completely in the background. As you can see friends, completely everything. Everything is there in the background now, right now. And now let's see how many games will be there in the RAM management by using this kind of high performance mode. That is what I'm going to check. So normally the Realme Exynos Max used to open only 5 or 6 games, that's it. 5 to 6 games only. It used to keep in the background memory, not mini games. So let's see the Crossy Roads, yes, not bad. And Smash It, not bad, yes. Till here it was completely good, completely same, no issues. And let's see the Temple Run. As you can see friends, the Temple Run, it got closed again. So even by using the high performance mode as well, I was unable to make this happen. So more than 6 games the Realme Exynos Max is not storing anymore. No, as you can see friends, it's not storing at all. The IQ 7 was able to do that really great, but not the Realme Exynos Max. And in terms of the Candy Crush, as you can see, absolutely the IQ 7 was able to open faster. This is a mini kind of speed test which I thought of doing just to demonstrate using the high performance mode will it affect or not. The speed test might affect it, yeah, the speed test did affect in terms of opening the really faster games in this phone, but not the RAM management. RAM management, I did not see any kind of improvement during this process of demonstration. So thank you for watching this video, friends, and see you in the next video on Nintendo Stato for more updates. In case if you want me to include any kind of different applications or games in the speed test, let me know in the comment section below. So definitely I'll be able to use those kind of applications and games in my testing as well. See you in the next video, friends. Stay tuned for more updates. Bye.